हेलो
सर,
हेलो,
मिटिगेशन मेजर्स फॉर रिवर्सल ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज।
वेरी गुड। सो मिटिगेशन मेजर्स फॉर रिवर्सल ऑफ द क्लाइमेट चेंज, एंड इफ यू रिकॉल प्रॉपरली देन आई डिस्कस्ड द नेशनल अप्रोच एज वेल एज द अप्रोच एट द इंटरनेशनल लेवल और ग्लोबल लेवल, एंड आई डिस्कस्ड एट लेंथ what are the important sectors under the energy which could certainly reduce the emission of the greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. Besides that, what are the other approach which can increase the sink, which again will ameliorate the problem or mitigate the problem of the climate change, or which will enhance the process or accelerate the process for the reversal of the climate change. So is there any doubt related to the previous class, previous lecture? No. So if there is no question from anyone, then I proceed to the next, that is the international agreement which in turn are helpful for reversal of the climate change, and that is called treaties. Environmental treaties, international environmental treaties. Here, if you read it, let me share the first screen. Then I think the screen is visible to all of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. So environmental treaties, international environmental treaties are the official agreement. Here, if you look, official agreement between different countries to work together to mitigate or control different environmental issues. It means the treaties, it's not the personal, or you can say the only unofficial guidelines or agreement. It is official agreement between different countries, and it may be between two countries or among the countries. You should note it. It is not always the fact that agreement, official agreement, is only being made between two countries only. It may be among the different countries also. So official agreement between different countries to work together to mitigate or control different environmental issues. There are about 95 international treaties on different environmental issues, and these 95 international treaties are under the following heads. Means there are certain treaties, international treaties, are as a general, considered as a general. But most of the treaties are very specific, like under atmosphere, freshwater resources, hazardous substances, marine environment, and then marine living resources, nature conservation and terrestrial living resources, noise pollution, nuclear safety. Yeah, safety. Main international environmental treaties are. Let me come to this, and this is our business here today. That what are the important international treaties which have been under the enforcement right from the beginning, from the 1975 onwards, because the first official document was released on 5th June during the 1972 at Rio de Janeiro, which I have already mentioned in the previous class. And again, I reiterated that was the first turning point to take care or protect our environment and earth. So under these environmental international environmental treaties, let us discuss one by one. Aarhus Convention, 1998. The Aarhus is a city in Europe, and many convention name is on the basis of the city where the convention or conferences have been scheduled or held. On the basis of that, the name of the convention or name of the treaties have been given. So Aarhus Convention 1998, the Aarhus Convention is a multilateral environmental agreement through which the opportunities for citizens to access environmental information are increased and transparent and reliable regulation procedure is secured. It means it is a first criteria, it is a multilateral. I mentioned you that there are two aspects. Some conventions, some treaties may take care between the two countries or among the countries. So bilateral and multilateral agreement. And second option is the subject wise, means option wise, means area wise, domain wise, it is not two only or one only, multilateral. So these are the two aspects. The Aarhus Convention is a multilateral environmental agreement. Kya karta hai? Through which the opportunities for citizens to access environmental information are increased. Earlier it was a confidential document, but due to this treaties, it was opened to all and to a common man. An increased transparent and reliable regulation procedure is secured so that the misuse, why it was made? Because if it is so much confidential, if it is so much protected, these documents from the public, what will happen? If the misuse occurs, then some people, the power, it will be under certain only identified people and it will be monopoly of this. Second is, someone may, the common propagation or the common awareness will not occur if it is confidential or it is protected. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Very good. It is also known as, iska dusra naam kya hai, Aarhus Convention ka. It is also known as the UNEC Convention on Access to Information, Public Participation in Decision Making, and Access to Justice in Environmental Matters. And what is the characteristics of this agreement? It was signed by 45 states, means country, 45 countries on 25th June 1998 in the Danish city of Aarhus. So in the Aarhus country, the Danish city mein, is 45 countries ne signed kiya hai is agreement ko on the 25th June 1998 and entered in force on 30th October 2001. Means agreement was signed on the 25th June, but it was enacted practically on 30th October 2001. This convention, what does it do, or what is the provision under this convention, or this rather treaty of convention? Nahi bolna chahiye. Once the convention or the document in the convention has been signed, then it becomes a treaty. So this treaty grants the public rights regarding access to information related to environment. Public rights here. Public access to information and public participation and access to justice. Governmental decision-making processes on matters concerning the local, national, and transboundary environment. What do you mean by the transboundary environment? Anyone? What do you mean by this term, transboundary environment? Anyone?
Sir, the environmental feature between in the border areas, means between two countries.
No, between two countries, theek hai tumhara, you are up to some extent correct, but not very clearly you have mentioned the fact. Anyone else? Transboundary. Anyone? Amisha?
Sir, I think like transboundary is beyond the boundaries of one country. Like
This is the only.
Okay.
I got the answer, and this is the only answer, that the transboundary means beyond the boundary of territory of any country, that is called transboundary boundary. It may be between three country, four country, jo bhi ho. India ka jaise border hai, border ke paas baad mein ab ja jate hain to China bhi pad sakta, Afghanistan bhi hai, Pakistan bhi hai, transboundary. So transboundary situation is very difficult to be managed. You know very well. Therefore, it is a national and transboundary environment. Ek to national nation ke antargat inside the country. What are the situation? What are the measures we are taking? And beyond the country, beyond the border of the country, that is transboundary environment. We have to look that. We have to gather the data, information, make it the storage of the data, and at the time of need, retrieval of the data is also essentially important as much as collection of the data. Then we are coming to the second treaties, and this is very important. I mentioned in the previous class also about it. United Nations Framework Convention on the Climate Change. यहाँ तीन C लगेगा, sorry. Here is the 3C. And here it will be also 3C. Because it is United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC. So it is very important. दो प्रोटोकॉल और दो ट्रीटीज बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. यूनाइटेड नेशन फ्रेमवर्क, सॉरी यूनाइटेड नेशन फ्रेमवर्क कन्वेंशन ऑन द क्लाइमेट चेंज एंड क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल. देन व्हाट इज द यूएनएफसीसी? इंटरनेशनल एनवायरमेंटल ट्रीटी निगोशिएटेड एट द अर्थ समिट हेल्ड इन रियो डी जेनेरो फ्रॉम 3 टू 14th जून 1992. If you recall, just in the beginning, I mentioned one date and year at the same city. Can anyone tell what was the date and what was the year? Same city, event of the at the same city. Anyone?
So 5th June 1972.
Very good.
Yes.
Very good, Dibyansu. Correct. That is, I mentioned that. 5th जून इसीलिए वर्ल्ड वाटर सॉरी वर्ल्ड एनवायरनमेंट डे मनाया जाता है बिकॉज ऑन 5th जून 1972 द फर्स्ट डॉक्यूमेंट्स वाज रिलीज्ड रिलेटेड टू द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ द एनवायरनमेंट. सो द व्हाई आई आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन टू यू बिकॉज हियर यू हैव टू सी आफ्टर एग्जैक्टली 20 इयर्स 1972 1992 टू डिकेड्स द सिचुएशन वाज चेंज्ड वेरी मच throughout the world. Then it is called Earth Summit because the aim is to protect the environment, but after protection of the environment we have to take care of the entire earth. So the objective of the treaty is to stabilize greenhouse gas concentration in the atmosphere at a level that would prevent dangerous anthropogenic interference with the climate system. What do you mean by it? Anyone? What do you mean by it? Anyone? Stabilize greenhouse gas concentration in the atmosphere at the level that would prevent dangerous anthropogenic interference with the climate system. What do you mean by it? Anyone? What do you mean by it? Amisha?
So I'm not sure, but anthropogenic, maybe the pollution that's caused by people or due to the environment.
Yeah. But the entire meaning of this inverted comma, closed sentence, stabilize greenhouse gas concentration in the atmosphere at a level that would prevent dangerous anthropogenic interference with the climate system. It is very simple. If literal meaning, if you gather from these, then you find that we are responsible. Anthropogenic is man-made interference, as Amisha has replied. That interference with the climate system should not encroach in such a way or should not go ahead in such a way that it destabilizes the greenhouse gas concentration in the atmosphere, which are responsible for the ozone layer disturbance and in turn the global warming. So therefore, this United Nations framework on the Convention on the Climate Change, that is a very landmark event, which was decided and held at, during 1992, exactly after 2 decades from the Rio de Janeiro conference. And you see the change at Aarhus. During the Aarhus convention, only 45 countries signed this document, but after 2 decades, the awareness was such, impact was realized in such a way that 195 countries signed on this document. And after just immediately, you see the change in the event, the chronology and the period. Earlier, after 20 years, 2 decades, this convention was held, long gap. But later on, frequently in 1997, only after 5 years from the UNFCCC, Kyoto Protocol, countries established the Kyoto Protocol, which is legal binding first time. This is the difference between UNFCCC, Aarhus Convention, or any other convention. The first time in the 1997, in the Kyoto Protocol, legal binding obligations for developed country. Mind it was not in for the developing country. Kyoto Protocol 1997 says that it is a legal binding obligations for developed country to reduce their greenhouse gas emission. My point was that the intensity for the surveillance at the international level, at the global level, was very quicker after 1992. Before that, it was sluggish. So the Kyoto Protocol and UNFCCC, in brief, I discussed. Then the next is Vienna Convention 1985 and Montreal Protocol. Kyoto Protocol was held here in 1997, but the Montreal Protocol was signed earlier. Yeah.
Sir, small doubts.
Yeah, please ask.
Whatever some conditions or rules and regulations that will be signed in the document, in the treaty, yeah, it will be same for every country, sir?
Yeah, every country. The detailed documents are prepared. And during that, the how much emission of the greenhouse gas has to be curtailed by any country, it is very specifically mentioned. What the funds has to be generated or has to be provided by each and every country, that is also mentioned. So what are the major approaches the countries has to take, that is mentioned. After that, once countries sign, they have to follow, because each country has its own limitation, own fund, own resources. Therefore, at the same time, the discussions are made. Please.
That is only the doubt, sir. Thank you.
Okay, so you are now clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you,
sir. So my point was, ये मुझे पहले आपको ले आना था वियना कन्वेंशन. क्यों? क्योंकि क्रोनोलॉजी में देखिए तो ये पहले आता है. इफ यू लुक टुवर्ड्स द क्रोनोलॉजी ऑफ यूएनएफसीसी एंड क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल विच जस्ट आई एक्सप्लेन्ड, इट इज ओल्डर. विच वन? वियना कन्वेंशन इज ओल्डर एंड मॉन्ट्रियल प्रोटोकॉल इज ऑल्सो ओल्डर देन यूएनएफसीसी and Kyoto Protocol. Let me discuss this. You can, according to this chronology, you can take it up and down or vice versa. Aap isko pahle le ja sakte hain, usko baad mein le ja sakte hain. Theek hai? Let me discuss it. It was signed in 1985 and entered into force in 1988. Aapne dekha ki pichla bhi convention aur agreement jab signed hua hai of into action mein आया है, इनटू फोर्स में, तो 3 साल लग गए हैं. इसी तरह इसमें भी 3 साल लगे हैं. इट वाज साइंड इन ड्यूरिंग 1985, बट इट वाज केम इनटू द फोर्स इन 1988. यहां किसकी स्पेसिफिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स क्या है? It is one of the most successful treaties which having 196 countries. Ek country badhi. 195 countries during the one FCC, young FCC. Okay. Then during this convention and protocol, the 196 countries. So it acts as a framework for the international efforts. Yeah, please.
What is that 196th country?
196th country.
Yes, sir.
The 196th countries.
Yes, sir. What is that extra country which added?
Okay. This country was the Saudi Arabia. Means they were not in the opinion to sign, but they have signed. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
So it acts as a framework for the international efforts to protect the ozone layer. So there are two specific characteristics of this protocol. One is international efforts to protect the ozone layer, and second, it has increased one countries to sign. So there are these two aspects. Earlier, there was no discussion for protection of the ozone layer during the Kyoto Protocol as well as UNFCCC convention, but in the Montreal Protocol, it was specifically mentioned to protect the ozone layer. What is the limitation of this convention and the protocol? The limitation is that it does not include any reduction goals for the use of CFCs, chlorofluorocarbon. Greenhouse gases consist, CO2, methane, N2O, and the CFC. But besides other gases, CFC was not mentioned in this protocol. What to be done for this gas? And what are the methodology or approach which can take care of this? So therefore, this is a limitation of this Montreal. So suppose that it is asked from you, that what is the limitations of the Montreal, what are the opportunities or the benefits of the protocol, Montreal protocol, and what are the limitations of the protocol, you should be ready to answer. This drawback or limitation is rectified or has been rectified rather when
sure.
The Montreal, yeah,
sure.
Please. Bolo
the UNF. So the UNFCCC convention was held in 1987, right?
Mm. Yeah.
Vienna convention has happened in 1987, and there was 196 countries, and the UNFCCC was happened in 1998.
Very good, Ria. You caught me, rather. This is a very good point. It means I am very much happy. That Ria listen very properly, or any students who listen properly, they can ask only such type of question, otherwise not. So I admire to all who listen my deliberation in such a way. It means any student, if he see or he is putting such question, I feel that he or she has listened the question, deliberations right from the beginning and very carefully. My answer is that Saudi Arabia again left that convention, UNFCCC, and up to Paris climate tak kuch chhota raha. 2016 mein ja karke US ne aur United States ne aur usne join kiya hai Saudi Arabia. Yahi countries hain jo idhar udhar karti rahi. So now you got point, Ria?
Yes, sir.
जो कंट्री आपका यही ना कहना था कि जो कंट्री मॉन्ट्रियल प्रोटोकॉल में 196 था वो बाद में कैसे वो हट गया और कौन सी कंट्री थी? यही कंट्री जो हट गई. हटना नहीं चाहिए, इसीलिए लीगल बाइंडिंग जब हो जाती है तो उसको हटना नहीं चाहिए, इसीलिए परसुएशन हुआ, पेनाल्टीज लगी और इसके लिए प्रॉब्लम हुई. जिसकी ये कंट्री 2016 तक ऐसा होता था. ओके, आगे से ध्यान दो, क्योंकि आपका आपने ना बिल्कुल किया कि ये पर्टिकुलरली So this drawback the red color marked sentence reflects that this is a drawback. So this drawback is rectified by implementing Montreal Protocol, which was signed in 1987 and entered into force in 1987, entered into force on January 1st, 1989. I think it is repeated here. So this one is correct. Yeah, delete कर देते हैं हम इसको, क्योंकि पहला sentence नियम में होता है कि जो पहला है वही माना जाता है, उसके बाद repetition होती है, उसको delete किया जाता है. So I delete this. Product. This is also one thing is important. What it aims means we are discussing the Vienna Convention and Montreal Protocol. It aims at the phasing out of the production of substances which are responsible for ozone depletion. Means you have to make all out efforts, okay, so that the production of such substances which are responsible for ozone layer depletion, they are removed. Okay, are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So this was the first universally ratified treaty in United Nations history due to its widespread adoption and implementation. What do you mean by ratified? This one. Sorry. Let me. What do you mean by it? Anyone? Anyone?
Sir, it can mean that this treaty was approved at a large scale.
Divyansu, repeat.
So I was telling that this treaty was approved at a large scale.
What do you mean by ratified? Ratified.
Sir, ratified.
Anyone?
Meaning change.
Change.
I mean, sir, पहले कुछ और थी, अब थोड़ी सी चेंज करके संशोधित करके.
No. That is rectification. That is not ratification.
Sir, here ratified means approval.
Very good. Garima is correct. Ratified means just approved. Okay, correct. Ratification means approval. Any document, any letter, anything. When it is ratified means it has approval. So, and it has been. Then second is the Basel Convention 1989. Basel, sorry.
Sir, when was this Vienna Convention universally ratified? Year.
Pardon?
Sir, pardon? Am I audible, sir?
Yeah.
Sir, when was this Vienna Convention universally ratified?
Vienna.
Yes, sir. Year.
It was not mentioned.
Sir, here I saw that only it was universally ratified. Year was not given in this.
So cool. Doesn't matter. Because ratified word यहाँ आ गया, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि पिछले convention approved नहीं थे. ऐसा नहीं सोचना. Don't think like that. But some sentences have been added. It does not mean that only this convention or this agreement or this treaties or this protocol has been ratified. ऐसा नहीं है. सारे protocol ratified हैं, सारे treaties ratified हैं, उसमें कोई दो राय नहीं. ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Basel Convention, 1989. It is an international treaty that was designed to reduce the movements of hazardous waste between nations. First time this hazardous waste came into the discussion. Hazardous waste, either it is liquid or solid. So international treaty that was designed to reduce the movements of hazardous waste between nations means transboundary movement of these hazardous waste should not occur, especially from developed to less developed countries. Because the less developed countries are developing countries, they are not equipped to mitigate the reversal of the climate change by that time, 1989, and they were also not able to have the state of art technology to tackle this problem. Therefore, it was mentioned in the Basel Convention 1989 that developed country to less developed countries, restrictions should be there. Okay. This convention is intended to minimize the generation of toxic waste, to ensure the eco-friendly waste management as close as to the source. Means the management of the waste should be possibly met out at the source where it is being generated. It should not be the transportation of this waste should be minimized so that the larger area is protected from this waste effect or effects or impact of the waste. This convention, which having 179 parties, was opened for signature in 1989 and entered into force in 1992, again after 3 years. But the countries were limited, 179 only. Why? Anyone can tell the reason? Why? Anyone?
Sir, maybe the developed countries, some developed countries did not approve it.
What they did not approve?
Sir, this was something against the developed countries, no sir? Because they should not enter the waste to the less developed countries. So maybe some developed countries did not sign it or at least approve it, like United States.
Very good. Correct. So Have you heard the name of Red Book Data? Anyone have heard the name of the Red Book Data?
The Red Book.
Red Book.